We have two very important announcements tonight. Last week we had talked about the world's light heavyweight title because we had to strip Brad Armstrong since he was injured and unable to defend it for over 30 days. We talked about a tournament. Because of the contractual commitments, the logistics of contacting the top light heavyweight athletes all over the world, we're going to have that sometime after the first of the year. However, the fans made such a strong statement about my top rope rule that we're still going to address that because I believe that when the fans make a statement, we got to look at it seriously. The top rope rule, as of today, is rescinded completely in World Championship Wrestling. There is one situation where you can have a flagrant violation which will cause for a call for an automatic disqualification. And that's when, if you come off the top rope and your man is laying prone on the mat and you drive your knee into his head or his throat, it's a flagrant violation. We got six or eight examples that we'll show you so you'll see what we mean right now. In this first example, there you see Rick Steiner climbing to the top, bulldogging Dallas Page off the top rope. That is now legal. In this example, in just a moment, you're going to see Ricky Steamboat, the Dragon, fly off the top rope in one of his high-risk spectacular moves with a cross-body block on the masked man. That is legal from now on. This is a more controversial example. Jushin Liger, one of the most exciting light heavyweights in the world. He comes off the top onto a man outside the ring. Again, that's legal as long as he beats the count back into the ring. Another very controversial situation with Ricky Morton, because it involves the knee and the man ends up prone on the mat. However, since Ricky Morton starts the maneuver here on the top, even though it's with the knee, the man wasn't lying prone on the mat when he came off on him. That is legal. In this example, Bobby Eaton, this will be a flagrant violation because he drives the knee into the throat and head area of Rick Steiner. That's a flagrant violation and he would be disqualified. In this example with the U.S. champion Rick Rude against the dynamite young Japanese superstar Sasaki, this would be illegal. This will be a flagrant violation under WCW rules because Rick comes off the top rope and drives the knee into the head and throat area. In this example again, Jushin Liger, his exciting high-risk maneuver. This is legal because even though the man's laying prone, he doesn't drive the knee into him. It's a cross-body block for the pin. Here's an example that the intent of the rule was designed for, to stop potential injury. Because when you've got a guy the size of Big Van Vader, over 428 pounds coming off the top rope on people, somebody could actually be fatally injured. This was no longer illegal. This is a splash. He doesn't hit him with a knee. He drops that massive weight on their heads, but it's a splash. That's not a flagrant violation. It's not illegal from this point on.